prism. To determine the refractive index of a prism, mu equal to sine of a plus d by 2 by sine a by 2. So we won't run the topic from base level of board to high level. This is a prism. ABC represents prism. BC is base of the prism. AB and AC are called as refracting surfaces. Through that, light can refract. N1N and N2N are the normals to the surfaces AB and AC. ABC is a prism. BC is base of the prism. Base of the prism. AB and AC are refracting surfaces. Refracting surfaces. Once again, ABC is a prism, BC base of the prism, and AB and AC are the refracting surfaces. Next point, N1N and N2N are normals drawn to the surfaces. Normals drawn to the surfaces AB and AC. I think so you know about this. Let it be, this is P and Q. From quadrilateral property of mathematics, A, P and Q is quadrilateral. Opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degrees. Opposite sum of the quadrilateral angle is 180 degrees. A plus angle P and Q is 180 degrees. Once again, in a quadrilateral AP and Q, sum of the opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degrees. A plus angle P and Q is 180 degrees. Next, till now I didn't introduce any light to you. Now I am taking the light. Let us suppose MP is the incident light. From basics of optics, angle between the incident light and normal is angle of incidence. Angle between the incident light and normal is angle of incidence. At the first surface, I am calling it as I1. And after this, light, if prism is not there, same medium, it can continue the path straight line. Once again, MP is the incident light. If prism is not there, it continues the straight line. Because of prism, light moves from rarer to denser medium. Velocity decreases. Because of refractive index increases. So the refracted light is PQ is like this. Angle between refracted light and normal is angle of refraction R1 sir. Very, very important thing and misconception of most of the students is this. PQ is incident light at the secondary surface. PQ is incident light at the secondary surface. But the angle between the normal and incident light is R2. This R2 is not refracting angle, that is incident angle at the secondary surface. Once again, sir, R2 is angle of incidence at the secondary surface. Next, the light is comes out from denser to rarer medium. Velocity of light increases, moves away from the normal like this. So angle between emergent light and that of normal is called angle of emergence. Once again, the angles are, I want to introduce once again, I1 is angle of incidence, R1 is angle of refraction at the first surface, R2 is angle of refraction at the second surface, I2 is angle of emergence. And one more mathematical property I want to use it. Let it be equation number one. From the triangle PNQ, total angle in a triangle, is 180 degrees. We know very well. That is R1 plus R2 plus angle PNQ is 180 degrees. From 1 and 2, right side parts are equal, left side parts I can make it equal. Then angle A plus PNQ of angle equal to R1 plus R2 plus angle PNQ. Angle PNQ, cancelled. Angle A equal to R1 plus R2. One of the important thing is A is no need of represent angle, sir. We can write it like this direct also. What is A here? A is angle of the prism or refracting angle. Very, very important thing for IP point of view, numerical, sir. A, they don't give angle of the prism. Sometimes they mention it as refracting angle. Refracting angle means nothing but angle of prism. One more point, they don't specify the prism type. Generally, prisms are equilateral, prism, equilateral triangle means all of you know, I think so. That is, three sides are equal, three angles are equal. That means each angle is 60 degrees. Once again, I want to say, in IPE point of view or in competitive exam, they don't specify the name of the prism. If they don't specify, you should imagine it as equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle, three sides are equal, three angles are equal. You know very well, angle of the prism is 60 degrees if they don't specify to us. Okay, till now, based on quadrilateral property and a triangular property, I got A equal to R1 plus R2. Okay, sir, what we want to derive here? Already I said with you, my aim is to determine the refractive index of the prism. Okay, before that, sir, to determine the refractive index of the prism, first I have to know deviation. One more term I want to define to you. Already I said with you, MPN is incident light, and this line, sir, this Q or line is emergent light. Angle between emergent light and incident light is called angle of deviation. That is, deviation is denoted by let it be small d. Once again, angle between the incident light and emergent light is called angle of deviation, that is d. From the property of triangles, let it be x and y, exterior angle equal to sum of opposite interior angles. Exterior angle D equal to sum of opposite interior angles x plus y. D equal to x plus y. Right. If you observe the diagram carefully, I am finding like this. This side is I1. This side is x comma y, sir. I think so you know about this. I1 equal to x plus y. Am I right? I1 equal to x plus y. From right side second part, you observe like this, emergent angle I2, and this angle is y and R2. So from this, we can get conclusion like this. I1 equal to, from this diagram, I1 equal to x plus y, x plus, sorry, R1, x equal to I1 minus R1. Once again, I1 equal to x plus R1, I1 equal to x plus R1, x equal to what? I1 minus R1. From this diagram, I2 equal to y plus R2, y equal to, sir, I2 minus R2. Right? From equation number 4, 5, 6. Substitute 5 and 6 in 4. Substitute 5 and 6 in 4 or from 4, 5 and 6, I am getting like this. That is, d equal to x plus y, this means this term plus this term, I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2, this, that equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. All of you, I think so, you can understand. A equal to R1 plus R2. Very important for competitive exam is D equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. Very important thing for competitive exam. This also important for competitive exams.